Cold, snowy night on the outside in East Grant County, but inside the Eastbrook gym, they're trying real hard to heat some things up and get a win. Good evening, everyone. Randall King here for the Grant County High School Game of the Week with Coach Steve Brooks. Tonight, analyst Steve Brooks. He doesn't have to coach until tomorrow for the Indiana Wesleyan Wildcats and get another win there. But tonight, he's coming in watching the Eastbrook Panthers. Coach, a team that is really, really struggling right now at 4-14 and 2-3 in the CIC. You've been down this road, all coaches have. What's it like in the middle of February, you're saying, just try to get a win?
It's a difficult thing, and I think it's as difficult for the players as it is for the coaches. The one thing that as coaches, I think we all, every game is different. You're preparing and you're believing that you can do it, but sometimes the losing wears on the players, and that's where we as coaches got to kind of try to step in and try to motivate them in creative ways to help them get that W.
Well, if it happens tonight, one of the people we're going to watch for is number 10, Ryan Mansberger. Tell us about his play.
Ryan is the leading scorer for Eastbrook. He's averaging right around 14 points a game. He's a little bit of a slasher. He's a long, athletic kid, can put the ball on the floor, but he can also shoot the three. So he's got a little bit of a diverse game, which makes him a hard matchup.
And talk a little bit about Jonathan Irwin, number 4, one of the freshmen playing on this team, a very young team.
Jonathan comes from a long line of basketball players. His grandfather was the head coach here at Eastbrook. His dad is the JV coach for Eastbrook right now. But Jonathan is a smaller guard, very athletic, very quick, does a really good job taking care of the basketball, and understands how to score it. As a freshman, averaging 12 points a game, that's big for Eastbrook.
So if they get a win, it's going to be a team win. They've got a team in Wes-Del coming in here that's not a conference team, but they're playing 500 ball right now, and they're at 4-2 in their conference, and they're tied for second place with three other teams. So not an easy championship or not an easy contest tonight. We will tip it off in just a moment. You're watching the Grant County High School Game of the Week on WIWU. And let's listen in as we hear the starting lineups for the Wes-Del Warriors and the Eastbrook Panthers.
Their experience and integrity qualify them to administer the rules of the game, so please don't hurl insults or water bottles at them. Now let's meet the starters. First for the visiting Warriors. Starting at a guard, number 3, Peyton Waters. At forward, number 4, Adam Ruth. At guard, number 24, Tevin Richards. At forward, number 32, Sam Smoot. And at forward, number 34, Sutter Foster. The Warriors are coached by Mr. John McLaughlin. Now the starters for your Eastbrook Panthers.
Back courtside at Eastbrook High School, the starting lineup set. Randall King and Coach Steve Brooks here with you for an exciting Friday night. Coach, you've been around Eastbrook for a while. It's a pretty good crowd, even though in spite of tough season.
Yeah, it is. Basketball typically doesn't draw quite like their football team does. I'm the student section has... You know, it's always been a positive thing, so.
Good to see that. Good to see the crowd out on a tough night weather-wise. Welcome to you watching live or delayed for the Grant County High School Game of the Week. And we'll start it out with the Wes-Del Warriors bringing it in. Looking for something early. Nice little give and go there. Didn't quite deliver. 34, Sutter Foster, one of their top scorers there, missing the layup.
Well, Barajas got the ball down quickly. Mansbarger takes a 12-footer wide open.
Both teams missing early on, but good aggression there, aggressiveness by the Panthers, and they get right back on defense. Wes-Del, as we said, in second place in the Mid-Eastern Conference, looking to break 500 tonight on the overall record. Won't change their conference standings. 24 there, looks for a lane. That's going to be, check that.
Tevin Richards.
Tevin Richards drives for the lane there. And coming back down, center for Eastbrook, gets it back, gets another opportunity out to Barajas. Trying to set something up.
Little staggered screen there for Mansbarger. He's a lefty. Made it natural for him to be able to keep it in his left hand and take it to the basket.
Mansbarger driving down. Mansbarger right now at 14.1 points per game. As we said in pregame, one of the two leading scorers. They'll go in now on the set play. Trying to save it there. Barajas can't do it. Go back to the Warriors.
Eastbrook has tried to force the ball into a tight spot. And typically when you do that, you end up with a turnover.
Oops. Eastbrook, as we said, kind of young coach, but size-wise, looks like a couple of tall kids on the Wes-Del side, but not maybe quite the mismatch we were thinking.
No. It does look like Eastbrook defensively right now with Mansbarger on the Foster kid for Wes-Del, who's their leading scorer. I think they're trying really hard to deny him the ball or want to try to deny him the ball if you look.
Richard's going to go in for the short jumper. He sees that in first points of the game. Tevin Richards, number 24, the junior, draws first for the Warriors. And we'll come back with Eastbrook trying to find something. Mansbarger now hits it out. He'll give it to Barajas to set it up. He sees something, goes in quickly, and with the backhand.
Hey, lightning does strange things to big trees, man.
We saw him run all over the field in Eastbrook football last fall, and there's some of that speed that he had at running back.
Boom. You can see where he could score some points. That's a nice release on the shot for Foster, number 34.
Irwin brings it back down. They saw something. 33 turns around there. That's Blaine Altum, but it's not there. Didn't really know where he was underneath, and Wes-Del coming right back. Adam Routh, I think, will go to the line. Don't know. Here's Barajas there on the replay, coach. You're right. He just went in with switched hands and really had it.
He had great body control. Being little like that and taking it in right-handed on the left side, he was able to turn his body and make the reverse layup over a bigger player.
Meanwhile, Eastbrook, 32, Blaine Altum got the fouls. He's going to take an early seat. And we see Wes-Del at the line, coming right back for Eastbrook. Now Irwin has the ball. Comes down quickly, back out to Barajas. Looks, now he's going in again.
Nice find, nice find. That was a really nice play on Barajas' part.
Just didn't deliver on the layup, and Wes-Del's going to come right back. Got to like the way both teams get up and down the court at this early stage.
Well, they're not shy. We knew that they were going to play up tempo with the way the Wes-Del coach, you know, John McLaughlin was talking to us before the game.
Another give, Irwin sees 20. That time he sees Cole Guinea, Kennedy.
Mansbarger, number 10, was the one that made the pass. Gave him the assist on the play.
Nice awareness by Mansbarger there. Drawing a crowd, passing it out. Now Barajas showing some tough defense, getting out on him. Good hustle by Barajas, just can't follow after the ball saves. Coming right back down, Eastbrook will look for it. Mansbarger sees it, coming back out. That time for Jonathan Irwin there. His first points.
That's a good looking shot. You know, he caught it in rhythm, stepped right into his shot, and he nailed it.
And Eastbrook gets the early lead, something I'm sure they'd like to see. Here's the three-pointer by Irwin.
He comes from, like I said, a long line of basketball players. He's got a cousin that's the starting point guard at Grace College on the men's team, which our men will be playing tomorrow.
Mansbarger brings it down again. Long shot there, no good by 20, Cole Kennedy again. Eastbrook will get a chance to retain possession here with the out of bounds. Mansbarger there slipping. Doesn't quite lose it, but man.
That's looks, a good effort right
looks
there.
Looks like Eastbrook football there, and they've got an awareness traveled. Right back down.
I think he may have got away with a little hop-hop in there.
But a nice quick pass to Cameron Wilson underneath, and we're at 9-6, Eastbrook.
Oh, got his hand out. Anymore, you can't touch him on a drive, otherwise it's going to be a foul.
Barajas gets the foul, number 12, his first. So we'll see Wes-Del with another chance. And a jump ball. Possession is going to go back to Eastbrook. 3:11 to go in the first quarter. Good fight from these Panthers.
Yeah, they've done a good job. They've matched the intensity level. Now it's going to see what happens. That's what, you know, pressure will do. Cause you to play maybe a little faster.
Coach,
especially
go ahead.
When you get a little fatigued. And then they turned them over right there.
Coach McLaughlin telling us before, turning around the tradition of Wes-Del, and for them to be at 500 at this point in the season, he really likes the way his kids are fighting. As we said, second place in their conference. This is a non-conference game. It really would be good for them to come in here to Eastbrook on the road. And that time, fighting, looks like Wes-Del gets the foul there, Coach?
Yes, they did. It wasn't much, but it was enough to knock him off balance. That was a heck of an effort by Cameron Wilson. And, you know, he stayed with the board, and because of his stick-to-itiveness, they were able to come up with the basketball.
Kind of see what happened here.
Well, he stays with it, and then he gets tripped. by 24 there. And
back inbounds to Barajas, and they got a little bit of pressure. Barajas is right around it, comes back out, quick pass, just doesn't deliver. You called it before, we didn't mention it in pregame, Coach, but before we went on the air, you were saying you look for Barajas just with his athletic talent and speed to really be a player here.
Well, he's a competitor. I mean, he's an intense competitive kid. His motor doesn't shut off. And, you know, when you have somebody that plays like that at the small high school level, you've got something that's special, even though he's 5'4". And he's so quick. It's hard to match up with.
Seen that all night. Wes-Del's back down on the other end. And
nice
that
move.
Time, good nice move there by Sam Smoot. You got to keep your eye on him. He's got 11 points per game on average for the season. There's Barajas again creating. And he kicks it out there.
Mansbarger nails a three.
Left him alone, so Wes-Del may have to look for something defensively. A couple of threes down on this end.
Well, and Barajas set that up. His penetration created an opening, and they had to help, and then he was able to kick it out to Mansbarger.
Wes-Del looking for something offensively now as Eastbrook goes up 12-8 early.
Oh, wow.
Penetration there by Adam Ruth, but doesn't deliver on the layup. And now a shot. That's Sutter Foster. Foster, Sutter Foster. One of those double last name scenes, but Eastbrook will come back out. That's a couple of times we've seen a kick out. And no follow there. Chance for Cameron Wilson there taking the long shot.
He's shooting 21% from the three, so he shot him before, and it must be a part of their game plan. There's Irwin again from the corner.
That time. Obviously off the set play, just not there. Irwin gets another look at it, though. He's getting close. 1 for 3 now from the three-point line. Quickly back now down to Wes-Del, but good swarming by Eastbrook. And the rebound. Here's Mansbarger with the follow.
That's a really good play. He's a lefty. He had good body control, and he finished with his right hand. That's a nice play.
14-8 as we end the first quarter. There's a long three by Wes-Del to even things up a little bit.
There was a mix-up on their defense, a lack of communication, left him wide open.
So chance, play it through the last shot for the end of this first quarter, and Barajas gets tripped up or loses control. I don't know if it hit his feet or quick kick there.
Well, they were half-court trapping, and I'm not sure the best way to try to beat a half-court trap is dribble through it, and he had to fight a double team, and he lost that battle at least.
Now Wes-Del probably play the clock out in this first quarter. Try for something good. They go for the runner there. That's 14. Gavin Bullock, first time we've called his name. Good play there, but Eastbrook will get a chance to come back as Wes-Del clutched the lead to 1. That time, bad pass picked off by Wes-Del, and they're coming back, but credit Eastbrook, so they're going to have to heave it. He had maybe 3 full seconds on the clock to end that quarter, but
it was impressive that he was aware of the clock at that point, that he understood that there was that a little bit of time left.
So the Eastbrook Panthers go into the first quarter 14-13 with the lead, fighting well. We'll come back in a moment. You're watching the Grant County High School Game of the Week. back at Eastbrook High School, Randall King and Coach Steve Brooks, and we've seen a lot of substitution coached by Wes-Del. But they're going to have to answer Ryan Mansbarger there with the three, so Eastbrook's finding something at the three-point line.
Yeah, Wes-Del made wholesale substitutions. They kind of affectionately call that the bomb squad, where they come out and really try to up-tempo the game and rat it up. In talking with Coach McLaughlin before the game, he mentioned that he wanted to try to get some kids involved that maybe weren't going to get involved in the middle of the season. And here we see the half-court trap, and they're going to get after it. Eastbrook's been able to find the hole and hit a couple threes against it.
Eastbrook spread out a little bit here, drawing Wes-Del out. That time doesn't deliver. I've got to ask you, Coach, about this bomb squad thing. I'm going to reach way back to 1980, which means there's two people that will know what we're talking about, unless you've seen the movie Miracle. Remember Coach Herb Brooks with that Olympic hockey team?
Yes.
Had that line he called the Coneheads, and he just brought them into certain situations. Right. Is that what the bomb squad is?
Well, I think it has more to do with North Carolina and Coach Smith back in the 80s. He had his white squad and his blue squad, and when the white squad came in, they would play like 2 minutes at a time and try to half-court trap and do some of the same things that Wes-Del's doing here. And it utilizes more players, gets them involved, and keeps them involved.
Meanwhile, back, Eastbrook taking advantage again, spreading them out, doing something a little different there, but not getting the shot to drop.
Oh, wow.
He turned around. That was 32. Sam Smoot, one of the leading scorers, but he just didn't know where he was. And it's a little ragged now, Coach, both teams at this point. Second quarter.
It's, you know, when you're playing that type of a game where you're trapping and your goal is to make teams play faster, and it's really important that Eastbrook understand they got to play smarter as much as they have to play faster.
Mansbarger with the inbound. Again, they'll spread it out. Maybe trying to match what Wes-Del's doing. I'm not quite sure offensively what I see, but again, no shot out of it this time. But Barajas gets the ball. He's going to go quickly. He was off to the races. I don't know.
You got to like his competitive nature. You've got to like his intensity. You know, he is competing on every possession.
So Mansbarger will take it back in, and Eastbrook will set up again. And what is this we're seeing? Is this trying to take advantage of their trapping?
Yes, they're spreading it. They're spreading the floor out and trying to make the traps a long traps instead of short traps. And by that I mean not letting them, you know, stay 10 feet apart. They're trying to get them to have to run further to make the trap and create the problem.
So both teams, again, they don't deliver on the scoring. And then Barajas, again, is calling his name a lot. He's kind of in the middle of every little bit of action going after the ball. So Eastbrook will get the ball again, 17-13. Eastbrook, the home team, winning tonight so far, but they are in a battle.
And now Wes-Del's made subs again. Nice play to get it in the middle of the floor. Mansbarger pull up.
Just the shots aren't there. They've gotten what they wanted as far as getting the shooters in position.
It's just hard because that kind of pressure causes you to play faster, and kids don't always practice. That's why it's really important that you get kids in the offseason to shoot the ball at game speed.
Wes-Del drives in. Looks like Barajas gets the foul. That will be two for him. See it real quickly here. Is that the hand on the back? Real touchy there.
Yes. That's the kind to get me in trouble. I'm not a fan of that foul because it didn't influence the play.
So Barajas takes a seat with two fouls. They're going to want to get him back when appropriate with his tenacity tonight on the court.
Van Cleve hits that. He's only averaging 2 points a game, and he hits a three.
So it's back to 17-16, 1 point margin. Now they get Irwin.
Good. That was a really good inside-outside play. Wilson did a nice job finding Irwin on the outside.
They've been looking for the outside shooters all this quarter, and that time Irwin delivers. Now back down to Wes-Del. As we should know, Wes Van Cleve again with a nice layup. Well, more than a layup, kind of a runner.
Yeah.
But again, Coach Eastbrook matching what Wes-Del's doing, trying to take advantage of what they're doing. So something they practiced here, something they saw.
Right. You really want to fill the middle of the floor. Wilson was a little late getting to the middle, but you want to try to play through the middle when they're trapping like that.
Checking in for the Warriors, number 34, Sutter Foster.
Sutter Foster checking back in for the Wes-Del Warriors. We mentioned before, he's one of the leading scorers. He'll come off the bench. Another big body also in there, matching up.
Good-looking athlete.
Also with the ball now in a crowd of some pretty tall players.
There's no spacing right now. They need to space their floor a little bit. Nice drive
by
Sam Smoot, another one of the leading scorers. That time gets an opportunity and takes it. And we're at a tie ball game here in the second. Eastbrook got a good look one more time, but it's not there. And coming back down the other side, looks like Cameron Wilson is, 21. Check that. Clay Dalton, his first, team's fifth.
Clay's another freshman. His grandfather is Dr. Fratsky, the head of the physical education, Division of Physical Education, Health Sciences.
Good friend and colleague of both of us.
Yes.
In attendance here tonight, lots of connections. So it's fun to do a game out here at Eastbrook and see familiar faces. Coach Brooks more than I do. He's got a cheering section here.
I don't know about that. The pressure is really causing Eastbrook to play fast.
Playing fast and quick shots. And you wonder now, Wes-Del's turned the corner, taking the lead, if some kind of adjustments in order for Eastbrook. That was
a nice play by Dalton.
Dalton got a hand on it, no foul.
No, he did a good job being over in the help. It wasn't his man, he saw the help. Looks like Eastbrook shifted to a little bit of a zone, 2-3 zone.
I'll try to collapse that, close down the inside, and that time Wes-Del doesn't deliver on that, so gives Eastbrook another opportunity as come back down. They're gonna go low, kick it back out. Mansbarger in low, lots of good pressure inside. So I was going to say, are they going to die by the three-point shot tonight? But it's just not there on the inside for them.
I'm really impressed by the Wilson kid and his ability to find the open man. He just seems to be very aware.
And Wilson will get a chance to make the one and one here, potentially tie it back up at 22. First one is there, clean. Here's the replay. You mentioned it, Coach. There's Wilson looking for the opening.
Yeah, he found the guy in the corner. Yeah.
Doesn't deliver on the second, so we're still at a one-point deficit after Eastbrook leading up to this point until this quarter. Wes-Del tied it. Now Wes-Del looks on the outside. It's not there, fighting for the rebound. That's Clay Dalton. They'll come back down. Looks like Mansbarger turned it over in his hand.
Again, pressure, you know. You just got to kind of slow down and see it. The Van Cleef kid for Wes-Del is really hunting, it looks like hunting his shot. For somebody that's only averaging two a game, that's a little bit surprising.
Wes-Del Warriors looking now, finding something again.
That's Smoot again.
Smoot again. So no answer for Smoot or Foster, who we expected to see creating their opportunities down low. Now the trap again. It's looking out Irwin, and he's got the handle again. That's got to be three threes. We're not keeping official stats here. But that's three for Irwin.
Yeah, he's got nine.
He keeps it in, ties it back up.
Oh, nice play. They set a screen and on the middle and then curled Smoot around and they were able to find him in there.
Smoot again. And Wes-Del's back on top. So we got a seesaw game here as
the scores you expect to see for both teams are stepping up. That time losing the handle is Irwin.
It looked to me like he was trying to catch and shoot it before he really caught it. He needed to catch it first and not be rushed. Wes-Del ran a really nice set right there where they screened the middle of the zone and curled smooth around. Let's see if they do it again. Right there it is. He ran it the opposite direction.
Wes-Del showing patience. Down low again to Smoot. There it is. And you're right. And
it's same thing. They screened the middle of the zone and just curled him around. And, you know, 4 points right there for Smoot.
Grant, that time drawing the foul, so a chance for the and one. You can see what he did there.
Yep. Comes right off. 20 was setting the screen on the middle.
Cameron Wilson picks up the foul. And what do you do when you get the guy by you? You just try. Smoot doesn't deliver on the free throw, but Wes-Del with the rebound and another foul.
It's really important right here that I think Eastbrook regain a little bit of composure and not go in at halftime down any more than they have to be. You know, they're down 4 right now. What they don't want to be is go down 8-10 points at a half. They need to slow things down a little bit and stay in contact with these guys.
Ruth with the front end there of the 1-1. Adam Ruth, the senior. We talked about youth. You look at Wes-Del and you've got 12, 12, 12 here on our grades. And then you look over here, particularly at the starters on Eastbrook, and you've got freshmen and sophomores who sometimes in another year might be playing JV ball.
Right, right. This is a learning year and it's going to be a hard year.
Irwin with the shot again. That time didn't quite get his feet set as well. Quick shot, doesn't deliver. 24-29, how big is a 5-point gap at this point in the game, Coach?
Well, I just think Eastbrook's got to try to maintain contact. The longer they hang around, the better chance they have of pulling off the win. 5 points is not insurmountable, but when you make plays like that that lead to runouts.
And it turns around to a layup on the other end. The pass just wasn't there. It was long pass, didn't quite get it high enough and fast enough. And
right.
Wes-Del makes him pay. Again, they're just passing again. They're turning over the ball as the, I guess they're responding to Wes-Del pressure.
Yeah, they are. And this is where being young, not having a senior leader out there on the floor is hard. You know, somebody that can take control and slow things down a little bit and make sure that they're getting a decent possession.
See if Wes-Del takes this possession down to end the first half, up 31-24, 7 points now. So what a turnaround here from
Eastbrook's gone back to their man-to-man defense. So after Wes-Del scored on those consecutive possessions against the zone.
Wes-Del's going to make him come out and get him or wait for the clock.
I'm not sure. At this point, I would go clear out there on the floor and try to guard. Yep, because you're going to foul. I think I would have packed it back in there and made them come to us. At that point, they're not getting rid of the ball. You're not going to – you end up extending your defense, and it creates more problem, I think.
Garrett Sisson gets his first foul there. So that puts Tevin Richards for Wes-Del on the line. He gets one, and we're at an 8-point gap with 9 seconds to go. They never want to see him score when you're not taking time off the clock, I guess, is an old mantra. Doesn't get the second.
Good effort by Dalton on the board.
Eastbrook with a chance now.
See the clock.
Lots of time. Irwin's going to take it down. Oh. Doesn't really get set for a good shot there. And we go into halftime 32-24. Real quickly, Coach Brooks, is that too big of a margin? What are they going to see second half?
Well, I don't think it's too big. You know, you're talking about basically a 3-possession game. The hard part is you lost momentum. You had some momentum early, and you gave that away. And you've got to go in there, make some adjustments on how you want to attack the half-court trap.
All right, we'll take a look at some halftime statistics and some highlights and see where we go. And we have some special halftime guests representing some great things going on at Eastbrook High School. We'll get to that in just a moment. You're watching the Grant County High School Game of the Week at Eastbrook High School.
leg to score. Lays it up and in with 2 seconds. Up ahead, Bradbury loses the handle. Kelsey Key has it. That's the ball game. What a finish.
Back at Eastbrook High School, Eastbrook and Wes-Del 32-24. We are at halftime, and I think they have kind of an interesting halftime show here with a little dancing going on. I'm kind of enjoying this. It's better than the little truck scooting around the court.
You don't like our truck.
I love the trucks, but... Hey. That was kind of fun, too. I don't think they quite do that at Indiana Wesleyan. We've got some special guests with us courtside, so let's go down to Kelly Reed. Kelly?
Thanks, Jordan. I have with me here now the Eastbrook's women's basketball coach, Jeff
Liddick. Yep, you got it.
Thank you. So, Jeff, I'm just wondering, after your guys' win the other night for sectionals, how was your reaction and what was the players' reaction?
I think my reaction was, you know, just I'm very happy for the girls. You know, they've worked extremely hard, you know, not only this year but the previous 4 years, getting to where we are now, and that's, you know, a sectional champ, a conference champ, and a Grant Four champ. So I was just extremely happy for them, and to have an opportunity to play in a regional is not something a lot of teams can say, because right now you've got 16 teams left in the state, and we're fortunate enough to be one of those. So looking forward to going over to Eastern tomorrow and being competitive in the regional.
Thank you. So we have one of his players, Haynes, with us. So after your guys' win, you're going on tomorrow to a regional game. How are you guys feeling about that?
I think we are feeling pretty confident. We had a great week of preparation, and I think we're ready to go play them tomorrow.
Good. Do you think something like anything special this year with your team that's making this possible?
I think we came so close as a family this year, closer than we've really ever been, and I feel like that's helping us a lot.
Awesome. Well, congratulations, guys, and good luck.
Thank you.
So after this break, we'll be seeing Eastbrook's athletic director, Brad Yorty. Welcome back to the Grant County Game of the Week. Here I have with me the Eastbrook's athletic director, Brad Yorty. So Brad, we just talked to Jeff Liddick and we really heard about how they're feeling about sectionals. Are there any other teams at Eastbrook moving on?
Sure. Tomorrow we've also got a group of 5 wrestlers that are going to be competing in the semi-state up at the Coliseum in Fort Wayne. They placed 3rd at regionals last week, and we've got 5 through to regionals.
Awesome. So do you see other... commitment and any other students, or what's that look like here at Eastbrook?
It's something that we preach to the kids all the coaches do through all the seasons. And we're a small school. This isn't the NBA. It's an education-based athletic program. So we really try hard to share the athletes. We don't own them. We try to give them perspective. We've got kids that are highly dedicated, but we also want them to have lives outside of this. We want them to have time with their families. So it's a balanced thing, but I think our coaches are doing a really good job of showing what commitment can do, but also giving them enough space that we don't own them. And that's something that high school athletics right now is kind of struggling with, I'd say. So I think we're doing a really good job of trying to teach them what healthy commitment looks like.
Awesome. So what's your next step as the athletic director looking into spring sports?
Sure. We've got to wrap up boys basketball season here. And then we've got a couple weeks to prep for the spring season. And then April and May are full throttle with baseball, softball, boys golf, track and field. So we're getting ready for that. But it's hard to imagine the winter's already over. It's gone quick.
All right. Well, thank you so much for your time. Back to you, Randall.
Thank you, Kelly Reed. Good to hear from the exciting things happening at Eastbrook High School. We are at 3:20 to go in the first half. 32-24 is the score. And we can tell you that it was a very, very tough competition for the first, say, quarter and half of the second quarter. But right in the middle of that second quarter, Wes-Del tried some different things, really put the pressure on there. And that was the difference maker. You can see here Barajas with the pressure. Great turnaround there on the layup. Barajas getting two quick fouls, and then Wes-Del coming back. So this was a Eastbrook game that was playing to their favor as both teams are spread out early on. And then Irwin gets a couple of quick threes there. He has 9 points unofficially right now in the first half. So one of the things that is working. And there you see Ryan Manberger, also scoring early, but he struggled in the second half. There's a couple of follows for him outside and inside. And there's Irwin with one of his second three-point shot there. What happens in the second quarter? Well, Wes-Del comes back with pressure, with opportunities. And coach, here you see Irwin again. He was about the only one in that second quarter who was getting something offensively. Meanwhile, Wes-Del was taking advantage of opportunities.
Yeah, you know, the trapping and all of that created some easy buckets for Wes-Del. And then they did a really nice job running that little middle ball screen type thing against the zone where they got some layups. But it's going to be interesting to see the adjustments Eastbrook makes coming out of their halftime.
See the crowd here on a Friday night. Of course, you said it in no matter what the weather in the fall in the football stands, it would be packed. But this is a pretty good crowd for a basketball night on a really, really cold night.
No, it is. It's, you know, Wes-Del traveled well. They've got a lot of people here as well.
So we'll take a quick break and be back to kick off the third quarter with the Grant County High School Game of the Week from Eastbrook. At Eastbrook High School, Randall King and Coach Steve Brooks tonight join us in the commentary as Wes-Del Warriors come in here to Eastbrook and had a really blistering second quarter in a lot of ways, really the back end of that. And so we'll see what they do. What would you say as a coach, you're looking for second half adjustments? What would you tell Eastbrook Panthers?
Well, I would like to see him slow down a little bit and play inside out against the trap, play through the middle of the floor. That would be one of the thoughts that I would have. I think the traps really sped them up, and they need to slow down and make the easy play.
Wes-Del lining up. Looks like they're more of their starters now back in. Same thing for Eastbrook Panthers.
Eastbrook's gone to a 2-3 zone, which they did late in the second quarter, and then went out of it when Wes-Del scored a couple of those easy buckets.
I guess if I could remember one note, it seemed like Wes-Del wasn't needing to go outside quite as much.
Right. So well, there you can see they like screening the zone. They brought the Foster kid in, and he screened it in and then posted.
So maybe the packing 2-3 zone will
right.
force them to take the long shot.
Right.
And they'll take it there. That's 34. Foster, top scorers, but doesn't deliver there, and Eastbrook just can't finish.
Mansbarger had it in his hands. He just lost it. Bounced off his legs into turnover for Eastbrook.
Couldn't get any first half statistics. We do know Irwin was three for six from the three-point line unofficially, but he did have 9 points that we recalled. And then Mansbarger had a couple. You saw those in the highlights. Come back down to the other end. And now seeing some activity there from Cole Kennedy.
Eastbrook did a really good job reversing the ball there, and he got a wide open look. That was really good ball movement.
Still watching to see what's going to happen here with the change in defense. A little pressure there, but delivers Foster again right on top of it.
Well, Smoot made a nice move to the middle and then kind of lost the handle, and it worked out well for Wes-Del anyway. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
Barajas brings him down quickly. He'll kick it back out that time.
Wilson threw it away.
Yep.
He had the right idea. He took it in, and he knew where the open person was with how the defense had shifted, but just made a bad pass.
Trying to claw back into this. Eastbrook done a few things defensively, try to put pressure.
It's Smoot again. Smoot's eating the middle of that zone up. They're doing a good job finding him, and he's able to finish in traffic.
Is that just all him, or is he getting some picks or some screens or something?
Well, there, he just made a really nice cut.
And now with the turnover, they'll come straight back down, trying to follow up. Lots of players down there. Someone get the ball, and finally Eastbrook takes advantage and gets it back. But now Barajas back in the game with two fouls. Doesn't like the call there.
We may be getting a little bit chippy there. I think Wes-Del kids were a little frustrated that there was no foul called down here on the rebound.
That time the foul called on Wes-Del, Tevin Richards. So Barajas will inbounds it. Another chance for Eastbrook to get something offensively. That time, good play.
It really looked like Wes-Del was confused as to whether they were in man-to-man or zone, and they didn't get matched up, and Eastbrook took advantage of it and got a layup.
8-point difference. Eastbrook's going to get these back, hard-earned points. They can keep Wes-Del from getting the easy ones. Still going down inside, back out. Smoot looks, doesn't take it. Going to go back around now. The opportunity there, that's Adam Ruth penetrating on the inside.
And that was a nice individual effort. He just put his head down and got to the bucket and finished the play.
Makes it back to a 10-point lead after Eastbrook tries to get something going. Almost turnover there as Wes-Del gets a hand on it. They go out to Irwin. That time not there.
There's an awful lot of dribbling on that possession by Eastbrook against the zone. I mean, I don't have a problem with dribbling if you're going to create a passing lane, but they were dribbling to dribble, I think.
Seems like a fast game to us, Coach. Not a lot of stoppages.
Oh.
Back underneath. Oh, what a play. caught him in the air. Peyton Waters finishes on that, but you got to give credit to the pass, too.
Yeah, that was a good find. They did a nice job seeing the cutter.
Eastbrook's going back out, looking for Irwin. That time he has defensive pressure, so they'll come back out to Mansbarger. That time's not there. Barajas finishes. Boy, they were glad to get him off, back off the bench.
Yeah, he's the Energizer Bunny. That kid just doesn't let down. He's going to play hard the whole time he's on the floor.
So we'll see if Coach Childs keeps him in even with two fouls. They need his energy.
That was really good defense. They walled up and made the kid take a hard shot. And we're talking about he's probably got 3 to 4 inches on each one of the Eastbrook kids.
Downtown, Barajas goes fast. Out to Irwin, doesn't find it that time, and Wes-Del recovers. So the three ball was there in the first half, not there now. Meanwhile, Wes-Del will take it. Not there either for Ruth. One possession each way, one chance each way. Barajas going quick. Mansbarger takes his three, and it's there. That'll get you a little closer.
That was another basket that was created by Barajas and his penetration.
So Barajas making something happen offensively, but they got to shut this down on the inside. How many buckets, they haven't all scored, but how many buckets has Wes-Del gotten underneath there, Coach? It seems like every time we're looking and they're taking a 2-foot layup.
Well, and they're getting it off the offensive board. It's Eastbrook struggling to get a good block out, and Smoot's done a really good job attacking the glass and getting that second shot. Someone needs to find him and put a body on him and not let him get to the board. They're back into the trap.
Eastbrook now down 9. Wes-Del being aggressive there doesn't pay off. Second foul for number 20, Connor Townsend. Each team now with 2 team fouls in this third quarter. See what Barajas does. As Wes-Del again getting the Panthers spread out. And comes back down the other way. You have to wonder, Coach, what would have happened in that second quarter if Barajas hadn't been sitting when they were spreading out the Panthers so much with the way Wes-Del was playing. Not saying would have been that big of a difference maker, but boy, what he can do with his speed.
Right. We'll see it here. You know, they're trapping again. And again, I think you got to slow down and make easy plays, not allow yourself to be pressured into making plays that are faster than you want, you know, especially when you have a young team. They've got to understand, you know, that this is a possession by possession game.
Back now, Eastbrook, Barajas making something happen out to Ransbarger, and he's got a long three, doesn't drop there, and right back down, Wes-Del. Looks like the foul. See what happened there. Van Cleve gets the foul for Wes-Del.
Yeah, he was trying to set his screen, but he had his arms out, and that's illegal, and it was a good call. It was a really good call. It was good hustle on Mansbarger's part to get back. But that long three again for Eastbrook created a fast break for Wes-Del. And that's where I'm saying a one pass and then a shot.
Not playing to Wes-Del's, to Eastbrook's strengths when they do that. Back out, 3-point opportunity there, doesn't drop for Clay Dalton. And Coach, do they play at the high school level as if they had a shot clock, even though they don't sometimes?
I guess I don't know. I know people probably think we are boring to watch, but I think if you can make a couple of passes, you can get something better. And, you know, just like this right here, they've reversed the ball now 3 times, you know, 4 times. And
lots of time to make opportunity. He doesn't finish it.
He didn't finish it, but he got to the bucket wide open, missed a layup, which is the first time Smoot's missed a layup in him.
But you identified it well. Their ball movement just in that little interchange there, that possession was just fairly brilliant.
Yeah, they reversed the ball at least three or four times, and they were able to get the ball to the basket.
Gavin Bullock at the line. See the replay here. That was the end of it. The Smoot doesn't finish, but then we have the quick foul. .43-33, we're back at a 10-point margin at Eastbrook High School on a cold Friday night. See if Eastbrook can claw here in the third with a minute to go. They're going to go back out to the money. Irwin, he delivers when they need it.
Again, that was set up by Barajas in his penetration, but he went under control and was able to deliver the ball where Jonathan Irwin was able to catch and finish.
If they could catch a few more of those threes to drop and also shut down what Wes-Del's doing on this end, they might have a chance here at the end of the third. But, boy, there you go again with Smoot.
Yeah, he's really hurt them in the paint.
I don't know what his average. Coach told us he's averaging 11, and I think he's almost got that tonight in the paint, as you said.
Yeah, he's definitely at his average.
There's Barajas. He's going to take it that time, and Wes-Del gets a block, fires their fans up. But is he going to go to the line? Did he get a foul out of that? Looked to me like all ball, but maybe not.
No, there was no foul call. It was a clean block.
Okay. So that's going to be Sutter taking a seat now. Sutter Foster.
Yes.
Apologies to anyone from Wes-Del walking. It's just that he's a great player. We're just having a hard time saying last name or first name. There's the block there.
Oh, it was clean. You know, I just don't like the standing over the top of the shooter and acting like you did something wonderful like cure cancer.
And there's Irwin again. He's got another.
That was deep.
That's going to be in the third quarter, and Wes-Del can't answer. So we go into the third quarter with those back-to-back threes by Irwin, and we are at a six-point ball game. So it sets up maybe an interesting fourth quarter. There you go. Congratulations from the fans, and we will be back for that fourth quarter in just a moment on the Grant County High School Game of the Week. Back for live action at Eastbrook High School as a three-point shot puts Eastbrook back in it going into the fourth. Now Barajas is going to look at a three. He almost sees it, hits the back of the rim, and they're back down. Now Wes-Del with a chance. Coach, are you going to see more of this passing from Wes-Del, or just going to keep what they've been doing?
There's a nice screen and then the cut. Wilson gets the block from behind.
Clean. Eastbrook's going to come back now with the chance. Barajas has got it. Wes-Del still spreading him out, but Mansbarger tries to pass and gets blocked.
You don't leave your feet.
Irwin's, Westell's back down. Rare three from Wes-Del, and that time it is in. And they are fired up as Reese Williams delivers for Wes-Del, and that gets back the three that Eastbrook got there. Three attempt there by
Dalton.
Clay Dalton. Just not enough as we're at the 6:50 mark.
Eastbrook got lucky there. Smoot again was able to work himself free, and pass just wasn't where he could use it. But
Smoot has just been all over that paint area tonight.
Yeah, he has.
He seems like he's always under the basket, and there's no answer for him. Brajas with the ball. Traps now by Wes-Del, and they'll go out wide. That time, delivery there. Clay Dalton for the three to keep Eastbrook alive.
Irwin did a great job setting that up, driving baseline and kicking it across. That's the kind of thing Eastbrook's going to have to do if they're going to try to get back in this thing and stay in it.
Got to keep from trading baskets at this point. Got to shut down what Westell's doing. Good ball movement. Not in a hurry, patient. Yeah. They're going to make Eastbrook come after him.
Baseline drive, you put both hands on him. You know, that was a, you know.
There's the three ball just a minute ago that cut it to six.
Yeah, Irwin made the nice drive and kicked it across the baseline. They've tried that a couple times and missed. This time it finished.
Now a drive by Wes-Del. And just like that, Adam Ruth is underneath for the score, and Eastbrook's just watching. Back to an 8-point game. 5:43. And the turnover there, Smoot got a hand on it. And calling of Foster, rather, got a hand on it there. And back on the other end, now Eastbrook does. Barajas is zigging in and out of traffic. Out to Irwin. That would have fired the crowd up there. Doesn't deliver. Clay Dalton goes up for the layup and draws the foul.
For your foul, number 20, Connor Townsend, his third, Chief's fifth. Clay Dalton at the line for the Panthers with two shots.
There's no quit in Eastbrook. There's no quit in Wes-Del. You know, you're talking about two teams that have struggled with their records, but the effort is still there.
There's Dalton going up, and Wes-Del probably thought that was a clean block, but draws a little bit of contact on the hand. Dalton back on the line. You're right. These teams are both fighting really, really hard. You're looking at a 4-14 team against a 7-8 team. Wes-Del's in a better position in its conference, fighting for second place and trying to break a tie, but Eastbrook, very, very young. They're fighting for the future, and they're fighting to win a game.
Right. Well, Wes-Del's coming in off of a big win over Yorktown, which is a 3A school. Wes-Del's a 1A school. So they, and Yorktown struggled this year. But still, you know, you're a 1A school, and you beat a 3A school on the road. That's got to give you some confidence coming into tonight's game, and they're playing with a lot of confidence.
7-point lead at Eastbrook High School. Randall King and Coach Steve Brooks on a rare moment. I'm sure he's coaching in his head, but a little bit of diversion for you tonight to watch some other great high school basketball on a cold night. Be playing Grace tomorrow. Some of you will be seeing this game. That Grace game has already been played. But the Wildcats also fighting for conference positioning at this point. We're back down to Wes-Del, and
nice,
they got another
pass.
Opportunity underneath.
There's Smoot again.
We just may say, if it's underneath the basket, look for Smoot. Of course, we come into the game not knowing these players, but within a very short period of time, you know who's going to be doing things, and there's Smoot underneath again. Drawing the foul. And just delivering a basket that time.
Sutter Foster.
So Foster and Smoot, the two players we expected to see, taking it down at the fourth quarter here, doing what they need to do. We're back out to Clay. And that time a three-pointer. Clay Dalton only 4.3 points per game on average, but that time kind of delivering some back-to-back threes there. Wes-Del with a rare kind of sloppy shot. Barajas drawing traffic. He's going to keep fighting for it.
That's a tough foul because he was out of control. And, you know, you're trying to contain him and kind of bailed him out of a tough situation.
Barajas, give and go, back out to Williams. or Dalton rather, and we're going to get Mansbarger with a three. He's not there.
That's a heck of an effort on Dalton's part. He came in there from the long corner and tied the kid up on the rebound.
See Coach Brian Childs there, and Coach, you said it earlier in the pregame, for Coach Childs, it's just about playing better each week and trying to be consistent.
Right. Try to find ways to utilize your young kids and give them a chance.
Wes-Del again with the rotations and movements that we've seen all night. No reason to rush it at 3:55. Now, dare I say, Coach Brooks, this looks a little bit like a Brooks coach team, you know. Maybe not entirely, but some of their ball movements, some of their rotations
Yes, they're a little patient. There we
come back down
three.
There. Irwin gets one just when they need it, and that's going to cut
five.
It to five. And now Eastbrook will take a timeout after that. So we'll take a timeout with them. Don't go away. It's still a lot to see as we're in the fourth quarter, 3 minutes to play. It's Grant County High School Game of the Week. Wes-Del at Eastbrook, and while we were away, Wes-Del drew an offensive foul, puts the ball back in the hands of Eastbrook with a five-point deficit, check that. And Wes-Del with a chance to cut it, maybe to one possession. Long three there by Mansbarger, and he comes back down, gets the pickoff. He's gonna go end to end. Now Irwin takes it, not there.
See, those are big possessions where instead of getting a shot and maybe cutting it to three, or you end up, it's a 7-point game again.
And this Mansbarger out to Irwin. This time he gets traffic, so he's going to go inside. Not there. And you're right, with crucial minutes down the stretch here, you just want to take advantage of that. And so Wes-Del will talk it over.
I think what you're going to see right now is Wes-Del may take some time off the clock.
We'll take another break. Don't go away. It's going to get interesting. You're watching the Grant County High School Game of the Week. At Eastbrook High School, 2:31 to go, and we have a 7-point ball game. Was close, cut close to five. Eastbrook with a chance to cut it maybe down to one bucket, but Wes-Del's just tenacious there. And after the timeout, coach looks like they're going to come out and keep bleeding clock or draw the foul.
I think what he's trying to do right now, if I'm, I think I'm right, but he's trying to play Smoot and Foster off against each other. If you'll notice, I think he's trying, you know, he's running Foster down inside against Mansbarger because he's got size. Mansbarger's 5'11", he's 6'4", but he probably has 20 pounds on him. And when he's not in, then they bring Smoot in, who's up against Dalton.
Wes-Del doesn't have quite as much pressure. Need to score at the end of a good possession, but
they're going to take some time off the clock. They know how. I mean, Eastbrook's.
They're going to make Eastbrook come after him, looks like.
Yes, and they're going to have to make, they're going to have to make free throws. You know, Eastbrook's going to make a decision about fouling, and then.
Yeah, we're at the 139 mark, so it does become critical with 7 points to make up.
Eastbrook foul number 21, Clay Dalton, his third.
Clay Dalton gets his third one there. Puts Smoot on the line. We don't have free throw percentages here. Smoot makes the first one.
He's got to have somewhere around 16, 17 points in this game.
Try to maybe get some closing stats, but I think you're right. We've just seen him, and he misses the second end there, so.
He backed off the line. He was backing off before he finished his shot.
Little opportunity, but Eastbrook really needs to score quickly here, down seven, down eight, actually. And that time just gets a little sloppy, Coach.
Now, yes, got to find a person and foul. Smoot's also their leading rebounder, so maybe we shouldn't be so surprised that he's the one that's been dominating on inside on the boards.
You know, he's very, very comfortable in that zone of the court.
Yes, he is.
I think he could just park a lazy boy there because he's going to be there a while. So the line now, not making the front end, is 14, Gavin Bullock. So another opportunity for Eastbrook. Barajas comes down quickly. Mansbarger goes in, can't deliver the layup. A little stutter step there. He's going to take it out. And where's the help on the rebounding end to try to get those opportunities?
That's a tough call. I mean, you know, he missed the layup, but it was a nice drive. He just didn't finish it. And then he knew, you know, he had enough to take it back out and look to try to hit the three.
Puts Adam Ruth back on the line. 57-49, 105 to go. Ruth makes the front end. Didn't quite see the foul like you did, Coach. Didn't know if we had a replay of that, but this is just the garbage time where fouls are going to mount up on you.
It's a part of the game.
So Ruth gets both of them. And we're back at a 10-point margin with Eastbrook really needing to score and score quickly now. Take it out to Ruth.
See, and I think that's the kind of play, at least that's the way I was taught. When you're in a game and you're down double digits, multiple possession game, and you're down, get to the hole because you got to get scores with the clock stop.
Right. So that puts Dalton on the line with a chance. Can't deliver on it. 2 points there. We'll see what happened.
This is another freshman.
Said just draw the contact.
You know, I mean, these are all valuable experiences for these kids.
There's Dalton. He'll get the second one of the two shots.
Eastbrook's up pressuring.
We'll probably see the foul. Yep, Irwin there.
Tevin Richards going to the line. I think he's hit his free throws today.
59-50. Eastbrook has shown fight all the way, Coach. This team that is struggling. They've lost two back-to-back. They've only won four games on the season overall, but some of those have been conference wins. Eastbrook Panthers 2-3 in the conference. Very young team.
Yes, but like we've said, they play hard and they don't quit.
back to a 10-point margin, and now Eastbrook will push quickly as we're inside the one-minute mark. Rojas back over. No one in position. Barajas is going to try to create it. Looks like he was trying to make a quick pass out to Mansbarger. Wasn't there. Not finding anyone.
Oh boy.
Pressure. Rojas back out.
I think
out.
You got to take it to the basket.
They're going to kick it out for a three. Almost there from
Wilson.
From Wilson. Now Irwin has to foul again. So you said it earlier, Wilson was 21%, 8 of 37 on the season from the three-point line, but hasn't delivered on him tonight when he's been out of position.
Right. He looks comfortable out there, though. It's not like, you know, when he first shot the first one, I was just wondering, okay, is this just out of the ordinary? But he has shot him, and he looks comfortable doing it. He just missed.
Ruth misses the first of the two. We're at 31 seconds to go. Eastbrook in these closing seconds. Back out to Clay Dalton. Long three, not there. 20 seconds to go. Wes-Del can just probably wind it down. Not even sure we're going to see another foul here.
There's a point in every game where you have a chance, and Eastbrook probably lost this game at the end of the first half when they went down 8 or 9, whatever it was at half. It just made it hard for them to fight back off of that. They needed to stay in contact with them.
61-50, and really a contest that at times was a lot closer than that final score reflects. Some of that, I guess, opportunistic play, three ball working at times for Eastbrook, but we kind of talked a little bit all the way through. What you saw from Wes-Del was a lot of discipline, I think, for a team that Coach McLaughlin was telling us beforehand has not had a great tradition of winning, but they're really turning around. He likes the way his players are playing right now.
Yeah, and then they beat Yorktown, they've come in here, they beat Eastbrook. And like you said, they played with a real understanding of who they are and who their players are, and made it hard on Eastbrook. And Eastbrook didn't quit, though. Those kids had fight in them all the way through to the end.
Okay, well, we will take a break and come back and look at some of this second half action. Also, try to talk to the Eastbrook coach and see how we proceed through the rest of the season. So we got some more wrap up for you from Eastbrook High School on the Grant County High School Game of the Week. Don't go away.
Why do I get up so early? Why do I brave the elements? Why do I endure the extra mile? Why do I spend so much time in the gym? Why do I push for that one extra rep? Why do I do it? I do it for my brothers. Because if you want to be first, find a way to be third. As iron sharpens iron, so one person sharpens another. My name is Bob Peters, and I'm fearless to be third.
Fills it.
61-50 as the Eastbrook Panthers fight hard tonight, but don't come away with the win. Let's go down to Kelly Reed with Coach Childs. Kelly?
Thanks, Randall. So, Coach, this was such a close game. Your guys seemed to really hold strong even to the end. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think we gave pretty good effort. The game was probably lost there in that second quarter. They made a run at us, and we didn't do a very good job handling their pressure. And, you know, it was an uphill battle, you know, and we just really don't have the firepower. Our kids play hard. They work hard. But when we dig ourselves a hole, it makes things tough.
So how do you think Jonathan Irwin played tonight?
Well, I mean, you know, for a 5'6 freshman, he's had a tremendous year for us. We need him to shoot well. We need him to score the ball. And I think he did both of those things tonight.
What was the main mentality of your team throughout this whole game?
Well, we had to try to handle their press or their pressure, and we didn't do a very good job. We turned the ball over a little too much. But we did keep fighting, and that's a pretty good team and an experienced team. And, you know, at the end, I think we had two freshmen, you know, two sophomores and a senior on the floor. So we're gaining some valuable experience, but we need to be able to put four quarters together.
So I'm sure you're eager going into the locker room and speaking to them. What are you planning on saying?
Well, that we need to put four quarters together, that the effort's been there. It was there again tonight, but, you know, we just had that little dry spell where we couldn't handle the press and we couldn't make a shot, it seemed. And, you know, we just got to keep coming in every day trying to get better.
So how are you guys looking forward to future games?
Well, we're down to four games on our schedule plus the tournament, so we need to regroup and try to get ready to play Tuesday night.
All right. Thank you so much, Coach.
Thank you.
Back to you, Randall.
Coach Brian Childs, and a little bit of extracurricular activity there that you get at the end of a game. Coach, you know some of these players. You know you go to church with some of the people connected to the Eastbrook program. What do you make of another night like this, but what do you build on if you're Coach Childs and trying to see where this goes next?
Well, I think you just got to try to stay positive. You got a young team that has been in a lot of games. They were in this game. There was a point in this game where they had a chance. They cut it to five and then maybe to four even, and getting them to understand big possessions and, you know, I just think for them right now, the experience, it'll be interesting to see these kids when they're juniors and seniors. You know, hopefully they can take from this and be excited about the opportunity. And by the time they get to be juniors and seniors, they could do something really special. The eighth grade program here at Eastbrook is really good. And so you're going to bring that group up into a freshman group that's playing varsity, basically. And between those two classes, basketball at Eastbrook could take a major step up.
Well, you do see a lot of players that are going to build off these experiences, remember these different teams that have come in here and trying to do that. I know they'd like to get a win at this point. We can see some of that second half, the way it unfolded. We'll come back and see those highlights in just a moment. Okay. And maybe break down, wrap things up on the Grant County High School Game of the Week from
God brought me here to make me who I am today, a servant to him, a servant to my team, fearless to be third. Our success came from within, commitment to hard work, training, and relentless practice. But our success on the court was only the beginning. Because we all play for something greater than ourselves. For from him, and through him, and for him are all things. To him be the glory forever. Amen. My name is DJ Bettinger. And thanks to Indiana Wesleyan, I'm fearless to start this next chapter in life.
Back live at Eastbrook High School, Randall King and Coach Steve Brooks. Let's take a look at those second half highlights. A tough second half. Coach, what did Wes-Del do here in the second half that really was tough to deliver? We see Eastbrook with a little spark here and there.
Yeah, well, Brajas brought the energy, penetrated, got a layup. They hurt. Wes-Del hurt Eastbrook on the inside. They were able to attack the zone and get it into the paint. There, again, Brajas penetrates, kicks out, and they get a wide open three. Here he makes another nice kick out to Irwin. Irwin nails the three.
And there were spots in there where it's 6-point margin, 7-point margin. You say, okay, something's going to happen.
Right. You know, they had a chance, but then, you know, miss a shot there, here or there, and then give up the easy stuff inside. And, you know, that hurts you. You know, like right there, another layup. Here's a layup that, you know, Smoot gets the rebound, puts it back up and in.
And Smoot was just all over. We kept calling his number and over and over again. His awareness on those rebounds and turning back around.
Yeah.
Just powerful.
Yeah, and he was the difference maker in the game tonight.
Well, we look at a CIC race in which Oak Hill is standing up there almost on its own tonight. If you're watching the stream live, you probably maybe know that Oak Hill beat Blackford 74-13. Our next game will be Marion, a non-conference game, but a big Grant County rivalry. Marion going in to Oak Hill. What do you know about the 3A school coming to the ranked 2A school to their home court? What can you say about what that means for Grant County basketball?
I think it's great. I think it goes back to the one class system in Indiana high school basketball when, you know, you had those teams fighting it out for a sectional championship. It'll be an interesting night at Oak Hill. I'm sure the place will be packed, and it'll be like old times when the county schools had a chance to knock off the big school.
So that game will be live on Tuesday evening, depending on when you're watching it. Replays on television afterwards. But if you can't be there, watch the stream at WIWUTV.com on Tuesday night, because you're going to want to experience that one live. Coach, some closing thoughts on the Eastbrook Panthers. We've talked all night about their youth and rebuilding, and you know what it's like to rebuild. Where do they go from here?
Well, I think there's a really solid foundation. I think they've got to just continue to play hard. I know what I would try to do is maybe set some goals on the inside of the game, just little things where they could take some confidence from.
Okay, thank you, Coach Steve Brooks. Good to be sitting next to you, and thank you for joining us on the Grant County High School Game of the Week. Tune in next time.